Are you asking me on a date? I'm too old for you, darling.
You're the perfect age for me.
Guys, I want to fight Tamino. Like, no caps. Hey guys, welcome back to yet another exciting video from Deb Deb. Today's video is the review of the Men's Club Season 3 Episode 5 titled Nothing Stays Hidden. If this is your first time of coming across my channel, please do well by hitting the subscribe button to join us on this channel. On this channel, I create videos that are informative, educating on food, air, and things I love and I'm side-eyeing. So, without further ado, let's get started with today's review. Today's review started from the last scene of where they left off in the last episode. If you've not seen my last review, please I'll drop a link and you just go check it out. Also, you know, where they left it off in the last scene, we saw Aminu sighting Tuminu and you know that shock that all of they are just looking at themselves and doing competition. That's where we continue from, Sha. And see, guys, I was so angry at this scene because I'm like, okay, this staring. Thank you for the staring competition. So, we cannot even decide who is going to win. Okay, actually, I mean, you win this game because Tumina decided that, oh, she was no longer going to where she wants to go to. She now told the person she was with, oh, she's coming. She went by, say, see this one. Anyways, that one never pissed me off. Aminu was not there standing. He did not go after her. And then the guys are like, Larry is saying, she cheated. I said, oh, gosh. Shut up. You cannot even see that this guy is love struck. Like, how we even see it when you say people have your own that they are battling with and all. But it's Lewis that is saying that no, this guy, you really like her, go after her. What about if it's a setup? Lewis is the only one with the thinking cap right now. The other one, you see that Larry, he has his own personal battle, so let's just leave him alone. Then after, you know, Lewis has finished saying, oh yeah, go after him. He now went after him. Hey God, I want to jump inside the screen and beat up Aminu. Like he's driving and then he's saying, oh, come into the car. I say, for what? Okay, for what? Oh, because you are rich now. You cannot even come down and say, Suminu, no, I'm sorry. We need to talk. Can you please come into the car? You just open the door, come into the car. I say, as who you are, as what? Like, whoa, like, guys, I was so angry. I was like, what rubbish, arrogant nonsense is this? But anyways, moving on. After that, though, Ogana drove her to restaurant. I'm not seeing him sitting there. I say, okay, what's going on? Sherry, do you want to apologize or do you want to discuss what exactly is all of this about? He now goes on and starts saying, oh, how are you? I say, how are you, Kia, dear? What is that? What is, how is she? When you saw her, do you think anything was happening to her? Yeah, she's fine and all. Then even I say, oh, I've even been stalking you. I know that you are doing well. So she's like, oh, okay, so? Like, no, seriously, I mean, so? You see, when they say you have money, does not mean you have sense. This guy's a dunce. Like, he has the money, but he does not have the sense. And the way he's handling this Tuminu issue is pissing me off. But I was so glad with the way Tuminu handled the whole issue. And even while they were sitting down, he still went on to be asking her, Tuminu, why? Why did you do that to me? I say, bros, really? So you still actually still believe up to this point that this girl did that? Like, no way. At this moment, I said, see, if Tuminu go back to Aminu, alone, I can enter the screen and slap her because, auntie, you are foolish. If a guy cannot trust you and just feels, oh, you are going to, like, he fell for that. It was not like she was naked or anything. Like, Oga, it's not a sensible thinking man being. Like, if you are so much in love with this person, you don't know so much, you can't even trust this person, and you are here behaving like, you don't deserve the person, I'm sorry. You don't deserve that person. I mean, no, you don't deserve to me. To me, you deserve a better guy. He deserves a better person. Huh? And then the annoying thing is that Tuminu has been saying she didn't do it. She didn't do it. Like, for so long. Since last episode, since last season gone, this guy has been saying she did not do it. Oh, God, you are not believing her. But if it's just me now, you will believe that she didn't do it. But no, something is happening to his brain. I cannot believe Tuminu. Classism. Like I always say, classism is the issue here. And guys, I love the fact that Tuminu told him that, oh, you need to learn how to get over me. I say, yes, queen, when you know your value, you know, you don't underplay yourself. Yes. And Aminu is like, oh, how? I say, okay, what is how? If you were able to believe that, you know, she did what she did not do, then that is how you should let go of her because don't be stupid. Oh my God, but I love the fact that Mini, you know, dead it and left that place because I'm in no beg. Like, I want to slap this guy. That's how the thing they pay me. When I was watching it, I was just insane. But when Suminu finally said, oh, girl, I'm like, baby girl, thank you. Walk away like a queen that you are. Period. Guys, and then, you know, Lewis is back to his house and, you know, all on him. And yeah, we had that. Oh, she had actually called him husband when during the old police saga, whatever. It was so cute seeing them back together. And then they were like, oh, you know, it's time for them to leave. And oh, because I was like, oh, let them go and get food. And Larry's like, really? I said, Larry, don't be stupid. I know something's already wrong with you, but don't be stupid. Go to your house, come on. Then he not, Lewis now said, oh, Tayo should carry, Lola's mom and all. That was like, oh no, Larry will drop her off. I say, you see, you know what? Tayo knows that Larry and Lou and Mrs. Tenny, that's Lola's mom, they have something together. And oh, I say, oh God, when the secret finally burst. Well, Larry is a very stupid fellow. That was how Larry went to drop Lola's mom, Mrs. Tenny. And guys, you know, in the last episode, I said, or maybe my last two review, I said, oh, Lola's mom might be falling for Larry. No, I take it back. I think Larry is the one falling for Lola's mom. That guy can fall in love so easily. I feel he's the one falling for her, because when they got to the hotel and they were talking and Lola mom was telling him about, you know, how she met Lola's dad and whatnot, and then were like, oh, I see where they will fall in love with you. I say, bro, don't be silly. Don't be stupid. Egbe, yeah, your mother's mate. Guys, let's talk about Tayo and Tiara. My baby girl. So Tiara went back to sell all of the items and refunded Tayo part of the money and all whatnot and all. And she was like, oh, when I sell the shoe and this thing, I'm going to return back what you so need, money. I said, yes, baby girl. Yes, you know he likes the money. It's money he wants and all. And the girl and Tiara was like, oh, you insulted me because of few thousand. I say, sister, my God, these rich people, few thousand, 600 and something. Seeing how many hours is few thousand, but it's okay, we are moving on. Nitoria is actually few thousand, you know, if we took at it. So few thousands, actually it's just 600 few thousands. Oh my God. But I like the fact that Tiara, you know, said, oh, you know, even if you were saying the truth, she shouldn't have said it to me in that manner. I'm not a child, you are scolding, you are not my father. And that is the fact. Like, even if he had the truth in what he had said, the manner at which he went about saying it was just absolutely wrong. That even the person you are telling would not even listen, because your manner of approach is wrong. It's just wrong. Oh, wrong. Yes, it's wrong. But I like the fact that Tiara stood her ground, said she's going back to her father's house. I said, yes, you know your words. Nobody's gonna treat you like a piece of meat. Thank you. Then guys, see this Mumu Aminu that does not believe Suminu but we believe Jasmine. And oh, he went back to the house and was discussing, oh Jasmine, what have you done that I don't know about that could have been affected, that is affecting me and all. And Jasmine, you know, maybe get played that role that you, what could I have done to you, do. And of course Aminu believed that. I say, see this idiot, he's believing Jasmine but couldn't believe Suminu. Can you imagine? You see, Aminu deserve Jasmine, period. Both of them deserve each other. They should cohabit and all whatnot. But guys, the game Jasmine is playing with Aminu. Guys, you see what me, I'm here for it, because I want Aminu to fall. Because Jasmine is taking, you know, information from Aminu and giving it to Patrick. And of course, Patrick is going to you to get back at Aminu. And I'm here for it. It's bad though, but I'm here for it. They should show Aminu Shege. She ain't want to be stupid. Ne? Okay, they should show himself that you should be wise. See Larry's mom, you see that script that she played with, that scene that happened between her and Larry. Oh my God, I could so relate. He came back home and his mom was asking him, I think he came back in the morning, oh, where did he spend the night, did you spend with the other mommy? I said, number one, this woman got jokes, but moving on. And Larry was like, oh mommy, I'm 30 years, you know, I'm a man, you should not be. And then the woman allowed him to run. She's like, then who saw, shut your mouth. Like, oh my God. When she said it, guys, I freaking laughed. I said, what? Typical African mothers. Typical Yoruba mothers. No, let me be specific. Yoruba mother. So go rubbish to face off. Then you will get no song. Then you will shut your mouth. You will shut that trap of yours. Oh my God, that scene was so funny. I could so relate. Oh my days, that script, that scene, that storyline, those dialogue were amazing. Like, they were real life happenings. That's just that. Let me just put it that way. Beautiful. No. Let's clap for whosoever wrote that script. Oh, Demi, you did well. Oh my God, Larry's mom is just a vibe. I love this woman's vibe. Larry's mom insisting that Larry is going to marry Shola. By the way, she said Shola is already on her way to Lagos. I said, okay, next episode, I want to see Shola. Let her see Shola. Oh my God, Yoruba mothers are just the absolute best. And yes, guys, if I didn't say this, between Fayo and Tiara, it's all over. Tiara is back to her father's house to understand herself, and I'm here for this. Yes, go and figure out who you are. Don't let a guy treat you like crap because of what you are more than that. So go ahead and figure out who you are. And if it's meant to be, it will be. That was a very good one of Tiara. Then, guys, the scene between Lola's mother, Louis' mother, and what's that woman's name? The second mommy of Larry. Anyways, guys, that scene when Louis' mom was insulting Lola's mom, I say, Jesus, mothers, they have to take a whole lot for their children. Because all those things that woman was saying, I say, ha. Lola's mother is not supposed to say so, accept all of that too. But she was accepting it based off, you know, she wants to try and talk about their children's future and whatnot. Because that Louis' mother, oh my God, if it's on a normal date that, you know, that children is not involved, oh yeah, come from Baron, like they're supposed to slap her with those nonsense she was saying. But Lola's mom was just even coming there, accepting it, that, oh, I accept if you say I'm a whore. I say, okay, oh. Even Louis' mother still have the effort to walk away. I say, see this one, kick yourself, rubbish. Then Tonye came to the house. Please, who invited this woman to the house? Who invited her to Louis's house? Louis and Lola were having a moment. Then Tonye decided to walk in with her belly, with her pregnancy, and then reveals what is going on. Guys, like, even Lola couldn't calm down. I'm like, actually, Lola pissed me off in that. And I'm like, baby girl, calm down. Like, your guy will explain to you. You can see this. Yeah, you can see it's a whole lot of drama. Can you just calm down? You're like, no, Louis, what's happening? Da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay. Oh, yeah, they finally tell you. So, what is going to happen now? Yes. See, guys, what do you think is going to happen by next episode? What do you think? Like, I want Toye to actually suffer. Because all of this that she's doing is not necessary. It's not. She can't break up to Louis and Lola. It's not even possible. They are not going to give her the house. She'll have a lock back money. How does she want to inherit the house? It's not possible. But guys, let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Do you want Tiara and Tayo to come back together? Are you also a Aminu and Louis sheep, or do you want Jasmine to show Aminu Pepe just as I'm standing that sheep that Jasmine should show Aminu Pepe? What is your take? And what is your take about Larry and his problem with older women, you know, professing love with them within how many months and does not want to go for people of his age? What are your take? And could you relate with Larry's mom? Please, guys, if you could relate with Larry's mom, drop it in the comment section. Let me know that we have plenty on this table. Let me know if you could relate with Larry's mom. Thank you for watching this review of today. If you haven't subscribed at this point, please kindly hit the subscribe button. And yeah, like this video, share the video with loved ones. Thank you for watching, and to my very next video, stay blessed.